2005, there was a fearsome conflagration in Madrid. A skyscraper went up in flames. It was a huge torch that kept burning for 20 hours. 20 consecutive hours. But in the end, the load-bearing structure remained intact. The skyscraper did not fall down.
Come ben potete vedere,
as you can see, the building is enveloped in flames. This skyscraper was not yet complete. It was still under construction. Nevertheless, it remained standing. Something you should note is the white color of the flames. This means that there is a lot of oxygen burning. If you look at the flames coming from the two towers in New York, we can see instead that the flames are dark red and the smoke is black.
The fires that were burning in these towers was a dark gray, a heavy, almost black gray smoke coming up. This implies an oxygen-starved fire.
To take and fall, broken trail on me, just when you think you left me blind, I need to, yeah, I will keep you in the corner of
collapse of world. World Trade Center 7, I realized this was something that needed to be studied and could not be ignored.
Building 7 and the Twin Towers share one utterly bewildering similarity: the presence of molten metal found in the debris of all three buildings weeks after the collapse.
Is this molten metal that we have now studied at length that came from these buildings and existed then in pools underneath the rubble of all three skyscrapers, both towers and Building 7.
A metallographic analysis was conducted by a specialized institute that examined the structure of a girder taken from Ground Zero.
Quando sono state sfilate queste chiavi, la parte che era sotto le macerie pare.
When these girders were extracted from under the rubble, it seems as if parts of them had melted. This is totally inexplicable because the temperatures reached by the fires could only have been 800 degrees at the most. To melt a steel girder, you have to reach temperatures of around 1600 degrees. How? It is a rather unusual scene. One would reasonably expect to see something of this sort. That is to say, pieces of the airplane, suitcases, debris everywhere, just like every other air crash on land. Instead, there is no substantial visual evidence of debris.